Alright, this is the commentary for my 1538 run in Castlevania Rondo of Blood for the Maria-only category, formerly known as New Game Plus. So, pretty different over Richter. Going to be doing a lot of cartwheeling, as you can see. We get that big heart there, so we can use the dragon familiar on the first boss here. Stage one. That will be coming up too. Obviously, rolling's faster, otherwise we wouldn't be doing it. This passage, of course, is also faster. If you time that jump in midair properly, you don't hit the ground and go into a staggered state. Luckily, Maria has a double jump, which is busted compared to anything Richter can do. So yeah, we don't really have sub-weapons. We have animal familiars, whatever. And the dragon is this great big thing that deals a pretty good amount of damage and has a big hitbox, so... pretty fast serpent so far. To have him at under half health before he goes into that attack that he started to do, but I killed him. It's a very fast fight. I'm taking damage. I was taking damage specifically during that boss fight. Because at the end of each stage, it counts down your life total and your heart total. So you want to keep both of those as low as possible at the end of each stage. Except for this stage. Because this stage doesn't matter. So, a lot of somersaulting. So, back there I got hung up on that bone pillar dude. What's happening there is I'm actually trying to, like, buffer a jump at the end of the roll to try and quickly jump over the bone pillar. Didn't work out, so you kind of just roll right into him. Yeah. So now we're riding on a boat, and this boat's going to take us to the next stage. This is, in fact, faster than doing the, you know, quote-unquote intended route here. So these guys, really it doesn't matter where you stand, you just have to not move and take advantage of the crazy hitboxes that these dubs have. They extend pretty far. Probably not as far as like Richter's whip, but as you can see, when some of these dudes start to drop on top of Maria, it's actually extended over her head. So that's pretty insane. There's really nothing to say about this section. You just kill mermen until you jump here, and then, yeah, stage three. Or alternate stage three. Not too much to say here. This guy right here is why I picked up another heart. Another big heart way back when. So I sit in this corner to manipulate him towards the left, and then wait for all three of his eyes to appear on the screen, and then just throw the dragon familiar there. If I didn't have that big heart, that fight would be not necessarily harder, but just more tedious. Not a whole lot to say here. Jump before that so you don't get hit by it. It won't kill you. It just throws you around. Doesn't even hurt you. So, moving on to Dewgather here. Giant eyeball. The boss fights don't get a little bit more... The boss fights really aren't that complicated until stage... I guess stage four. There's not a whole lot to this boss. It is possible to kill him before he teleports, but really it just comes down to luck. So now we're going to be moving on to stage 4, which could also be alternate stage 4, I don't remember. Yes, it is. It's alternate stage 4. Continuing with the somersaults, dodging these toad dudes here. You can get bad RNG and have those frogs hit you if they decide to swim high, which sucks, but there's not really anything you can do about it. So these frogs here all have a set position. The skeletons are random, though. Well, the pattern that you get is random, but each pattern where a skeleton spawns is consistent. It's just a matter of knowing which pattern you're getting. This section with Richter is obviously a little bit harder than it is for Maria. Maria can, she can just keep on rolling. So, moving on to Doulahan here. Those stairs there, people get hung up on them all the time, trying to roll over them. Sometimes you can roll over them, sometimes you can't. Most of the time, you can. So this is the first fight where I'm going to be using Maria's special attack, which is the Guardian Knuckle. Which is this little dude that pops out. I'm going to be referring to it as GK from now on. Just because. So yeah, I jump up, do a GK to suspend Maria in air, just to ensure that I can grab the orb. Stage 5 is... it's basically the run killer stage. That section's fairly easy. Not a whole lot to say about it. We're grabbing this heart here. We grab that familiar for one reason only, which will be coming up here in a second. This little mini boss. Very annoying. But since we have this familiar, it's true. Do a GK there on those two skeletons. And then we'll be doing a couple GKs on this guy. That guy, if you mess up, he will grab you and he will insta-kill you. He will put you in his portrait. That's not very nice. So, it's been a little while since I got this PB, but yeah, we're going to be getting GKs on these guys if we can. Sometimes I don't land it, and it's just faster to continue attacking them with the doves. These flea men that are flying around are fairly random, but luckily they didn't hit me. That's the only risk there, is you don't want them to hit you. So coming up in the death fight, this is the real reason why stage 5 is the run killer. Death's patterns? Yeah, it's a mystery. What we do know, though, is that the bottom of the dragon familiar actually does more damage. If you hit the top of Death's character model. So basically, you want to be able to get that to hit the top of his head from the bottom of the dragon, like, every time. And I actually got a very fast first form of Death. And then the second form, I just position myself to be able to walk forward and land 3 hits on him with a GK, and that'll kill him in one hit. Now, I kept 5 hearts here, mainly for a backup strat on the boss rush that's coming up. I don't use that in my runs now. It's like a matter of frames, really. But when I got this PB, I kept doing that strat just because it's what I was used to, but I don't do that anymore. But we're talking, you know, a handful of frames here. So I stand off to the right here, and I wait just before he comes out of his little startup iframes there. And then I land a GK on him. Medusa, same thing. GK, GK, roll GK. That'll kill her pretty quickly. Mummy's gonna be much of the same. Mummy you can kill with 2 GKs. Sometimes it takes 3 if you timed it wrong. But I got it in 2, even though I did 3 GKs. We leave the food there just because. Frankenstein, you can actually kill him with 2 GKs. Just sitting in one spot. But he has a chance of grabbing you. So I just do a little walk back and then jump in GK. It's 100% consistent. Is not really that much slower than the other strat. So here I GK, wait to see where he goes. He goes into that corner. I GK again, and I use the dragon. That was probably the worst part of the boss rush, was just that right there. Ideally, you can do that fight with, like, 2 or 3 GKs, if I remember correctly. But I didn't land the second one, unfortunately. So that was the first real mistake in this run. And it's part of the reason why I used to take the dragon, or I used to keep 5 hearts for the dragon fight. So this bridge, not much to say. It's harder with Richter, of course. The bat spawning is RNG. Sometimes you get 1, sometimes you get 2, sometimes you get none. So this part of the game has some fairly precise platforming. Landing on things, dropping off of them to abuse the double jump. I believe that was like the only platforming mistake was right there. The fast death fight really, really saved time over my old PB. Couple rolls here, jump over, roll, touch the edge so that I can double jump before hitting the ground. Unfortunately, I think nerves were getting to me at this point. Yeah, they definitely seem to be getting to me at that point. So, a little sloppy, but I did that section pretty much how you would want to do it. So we're coming up on the Shaft's ghost fight here, or illusion, or whatever you want to call it. We grabbed the bird familiar for a strat that we do when we have him around half health. It's much faster than the dragon wing. The dragon familiar puts out a good amount of damage in one hit, but it's lacking in sustained, you know, quick damage. So we actually let him fly up, and then we just throw a bunch of birds at him. Then we get hit, so we can save some frames. And really, I should have thrown away a couple hearts, because I'm not going to need 6 on Dracula. So we lost some frames on that. And I'm trying to remember if I got 3-cycle on Dracula here. I don't remember. But I guess we're going to find out. So yeah, Dracula fight. You're either going to get 3 cycles or you're going to get 4 cycles. 4 cycles is much more common. And 3 cycles is definitely preferred. So just by the looks of it, it looks like I'm going to get 4-cycle. It all just comes down to how you time the dubs. The good news is it was a fast 4-cycle. I've also noticed that when you get a 4-cycle, you tend to get a Dracula Form 2 that cooperates. Like Dracula Form 2, he can jump around and be annoying. Here, he just stays. And I noticed that's fairly consistent with the 4-cycle on Form 1. Yeah, that's Maria and Rondo. Fun little roll around the castle and kill baddies. Speedrun. It's definitely different from what Richter was doing in this game. And then there's some anime stuff happening that... is surprisingly quiet. I don't know why that is. Konami just like turned the volume way down for these cutscenes here. Yeah. That's the run. I don't really have anything else to say about it. Thanks for watching. And I'll shut up and let this play out now.
よく覚えておくのだぞ。 なかなか楽しませてもらったよ。 ベルモンドの子孫よ。 また会おう。